Welcome to Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
Today we have short workshop video. We are building a new blast shield thing. And Timo is cutting the biggest pipe that we found on the yard with the bandsaw.
Lauri, how heavy is it?
I don't know. 400, 500. What is Timo's guess? How many?
500.
Eikö toi putkiosio vai yksi toista kahdeksan?
198.
Niin siinä tulee toi keskiosa kanssa.
Se on kaikki siinä.
Okay, so it's now there. I think we are going to add some coolant in case we run out. And then we just hit the button and it's going to cut. And I check the time now so we can see how long it takes. It's 8:08. Hey Anni, what is your prediction? How long it's going to take?
37 minutes.
I was about to say 34. You can't imperfect that 1 minute. 35. How much I would have to pay for you to you cut this with the handsaw?
1 million.
Okay, we had to change the new blade for the saw, and now we are going to try again. And look at my box thing, it's almost ready.
Pretty good.
And at this point we realized that it doesn't cut all the way through. Or we actually like predicted it before, but now it was clear that there isn't enough room on the saw for the piece. But it seems that we are going to get pretty close, so we went as far as possible. And about on this point we stopped the saw and lifted it up. And yeah, that's about it. And here is the whole time lapse of the saw going through. And I have to actually calculate this. So it was this amount of time after we changed the new blade and went again all the frame from the beginning. So pretty fast. And this much was left without using the grinder to finish it off. And Timo made weld up here to make it easier to lift it up from the saw. Otherwise it would be really dangerous because this piece would probably fall out when you lift it. But yeah, it's now in two pieces, so job done. Okay, and then I want to do quick update on the saw blade launcher thing. We are going to film more next week. This week has been too poor weather. And here is actually the real use case for the thing. Why I built it. It should be frisbee cannon. And here is the sapo for the frisbee. It's basically the same as for the saw blade. It's just different shape here to fit the frisbee. And then I wanted to do even more material removal for the faster print time, so I made these holes here. And I'm also working on getting the saw blade spin. And I have got a lot of emails from you guys, so big thanks for those. And here is like, there has been many ideas about this same design, where I have the saw blade with the bearings on the holder, and then I get it spin. I think some emails said that if I just make hole here, it starts to spin when it's been launched, but I think there isn't enough airflow through here while it's been launched because it's so short time. So I think this first stage air thing, where I first just get air through here and make it spin and then launch it, that would be probably the best way of doing it. Or then I can just insert air here and make it spin, because this might leak here and push it like halfway out maybe. Or then I can put some sticky stuff there. But I'm probably going to try this method to get it spin first and then launch it. And I calculated that the acceleration is maybe around 500 to 700 kilos force here. So I think I can make strong enough 3D print to hold that. But that video is coming out in next couple weeks. I have no idea how demanding this is going to be to make, but I'm going to do updates also for this project. It's going to be interesting. Yeah, but that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.